Welcome, everyone. Our processional hymn this morning can be found on page 711. If you have the Breaking Bread hymnals on you, 711, Blessed Feast of Blessed Martyrs, 711. Blessed Feast of Blessed Martyrs, Holy Women, Holy Men, with our love and admiration, breathe we your return again. Worthy deeds, they wrought and wonders, worthy of the name they bore. We with joyful praise and singing honor them forevermore. Faith prevailing, hope unfailing, loving Christ with single heart. Thus a glorious and victorious, bravely bore the martyr's part. By contempt of every anguish, by unyielding battle done, victors at the last they triumph with the host of angels one.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our Holy Mass as we are gathered here today as we now shift into ordinary time, but we know that the Lord continues his extraordinary work amongst us here at this Holy Mass and through the works of the saints. So today we celebrate the memorial of two martyrs, Saints Marcellinus and Peter, who were very much part of the beautiful Christian movement in the 4th century. And so may we continue to pray to their intercession to help us to live out our faith and spread the good news. And so, my dear friends, let us begin this prayer, begin all prayers with the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, at this time, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who surround us with protection through the glorious confession of the martyrs Saints Marcellinus and Peter, grant that we may profit by imitating them and be upheld by their prayer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Beloved, wait for and hasten the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved in flames, and the elements melted by fire. But according to his promise, we await new heavens and a new earth, in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you await these things, be eager to be found without spot or blemish before him, at peace. And consider the patience of our Lord as salvation. Therefore, beloved, since you are forewarned, be on your guard not to be led into the error of the unprincipled, and to fall from your own stability, but grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be glory now and to the day of eternity. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Before the mountains were begotten, and the earth and the world were brought forth, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. You turn man back to dust, saying, return to, O children of man. For 1,000 years in your sight are as yesterday, now that is it past, and as a watch of the night. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. 70 is the sum of our years, for 80 if we are strong, and most of them are fruitless toil, for they pass quickly and we drift away. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shout for joy and gladness of our days. Let your will be seen by your servants, and your glory by their children. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
May the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ enlighten the eyes of our hearts, that we may know what is the hope that belongs to his call.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Some Pharisees and Herodians were sent to Jesus to ensnare him in his speech. They came and said to him, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man, and that you are not concerned with anyone's opinion. You do not regard a person's status, but teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not? Should we pay or should we not pay?" Knowing their hypocrisy, he said to them, "Why are you testing me? Bring me a denarius to look at." They brought one to him, and he said to them, "Whose image and inscription is this?" They replied to him, "Caesar's." So Jesus said to them, "Repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." They were utterly amazed at him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. My dear friends, as we dive into the Gospel of Mark, and really a popular pericope in where it highlights the tensions, you know, between the Romans, the Jews, and even the Christians of the time. And so if we enter into that moment, there was a lot of this political, social tension that they were starting to draw lines in the sand. And if, you know, you weren't part of this group or that group, that means you are, you know, against us, or that there is no peaceful resolve. And so they go to Jesus in a certain way, first of all, to test him, to see what side is he on, to draw the line in the sand. Two, to trap him, so that way they can be able to have some evidence against him, to bring charges against him. And so Jesus responds in a very powerful way, in understanding that everybody has their understandings of certain things. But ultimately, I think it's something to also pull from our first reading as well, about how we have to keep our eyes on heaven, to keep our eyes on the ultimate peace that we all continue to try to strive for each and every single day. That a lot of times we can get caught up in the earthly factions of things, or the social and political realms of things, that we draw the lines in the sand and where we can't even have a dialogue with those that maybe we don't see eye to eye with. When we come from a place in our souls that the heavenly realm is the first, we understand more deeply that that's peace that we strive for. All that I speak of, doesn't it speak to a certain situation that we are experiencing at this moment in time, where, you know, I've been watching the news pretty much ever since this pandemic started, at least 1 or 2 hours a day. And, you know, sometimes I can get drawn in or sucked in, you know, by it, that it entices in me almost a sense of just hardship, you know, whether it be anger or confusion or sadness, you know. So a lot of these things are stirred up in my own heart on a human level. And so then, you know, sometimes some of us, we would try to draw lines, you know, in the sand, and to the point where we won't even have a dialogue, you know, with another person that maybe we don't see eye to eye with. And now, my dear friends, I hope that all of us can be able to really focus on the prize, which is Christ and heaven. That if we keep that at the core, we can continue to have that conversation, you know, of peace. That violence, struggle, hardship, that's not the core of our being. God, at the very beginning of time, created everything in this world, and he called it as good. May we remember the good in our life. May we remember the good that we are built for, that we were created for, which is to be co-creators with God, to be one with him and his creation. So once again, I draw ourselves back to that first reading, my dear friends. Let us keep our eyes on heaven. Let us keep our eyes on the beautiful, the peaceful ways that we can, you know, be able to spread the good news, because that's what we are called to do. Now, I'm not trying to draw lines and say you need to do this or you need to side with this or that side. I just ask that in our lives that we come from a place of great peace, and that we keep our eyes on the Lord. That from this day forward, we ask for the helps of all the saints as well, who risked their lives, who gave their lives, you know, for the Lord. So may we do the same. May we give our lives fully to the Lord and enhance that peace in us, so that we can keep our eyes on who it matters most, which is the Lord. Dear friends, we have many prayers and petitions that we hold in our hearts, and so at this time we offer them aloud to our Almighty Father.
For the Church, may the Holy Spirit instill in our bishops and priests the gifts of wisdom and holiness of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected and appointed officials, may God move them to enact policies that lead to the flourishing of all people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are uprooted from their homes, may God protect them and lead them to safety. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for our community of faith here at Seas. May the Lord allow His word to grow in us through our worship and service of others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the world, especially during this time of pandemic, may the Lord send healing into our hearts and healing on our country during this time of pandemic and social unrest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially Francis de Luna, may the Lord welcome them into His peace and rest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We conclude with the prayer for protection in time of pandemic. O Mary,
you always brighten our path. As a sign of salvation and of hope, we entrust ourselves to you, help of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, while remaining steadfast in faith. O loving Mother, you know what we need, and we are confident you will provide for us
as at Cana in Galilee.
Intercede for us with your Son, Jesus, the divine physician, for those who have fallen ill, for those who are vulnerable, and for those who have died. Intercede also for those charged with protecting the health and safety of others, and for those who are attending to the sick and seeking a cure. Help us, O Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father, and to do as we are told by Jesus, who took upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows, so as to lead us through the cross to the glory of the resurrection. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offerings of your people in honor of the passion of your holy martyrs, and may the gifts that gave blessed Marcellinus and Peter courage under persecution make us too steadfast in all trials. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration. And we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, Timothy and Tun, his brother bishops, and all those who, holding on to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas, and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment light and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
The Communion Antiphon. Whoever loses his life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it, says the Lord. My dear friends, at this time I ask you to enter into that prayerful disposition to understand the Lord's great love and grow intimacy with the Lord at this time through spiritual communion. And so I'd like to lead you at this time in the prayer of spiritual communion, since you cannot partake of him physically. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Preserve in us your gift, O Lord, and may what we have received at your hands for the feast day of the blessed martyrs Marcellinus and Peter bring us salvation and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My dear friends, just a friendly reminder here that since it is the first week of the month of June, the first Tuesday of the month in June, we will have adoration. And so after the Mass here, Father Paul will go ahead and lead you in virtual adoration for the next hour or so. So I invite you to, if you can, please stay and spend some intimate time with the Lord to pray for peace in our world and for an end of violence, as well as healing for the pandemic as well. And also for, if I can just plug in, also for our seminarians and for vocations and those who are to be ordained this Saturday too. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Wish you a very beautiful day, everyone, and a prayerful one as well. And we'll go ahead and sing the same song that we did coming in on 7:11 in the Breaking Bread hymnals, Blessed Feast of Blessed Martyrs, 7:1:1, and verse number 3.
Therefore, all that reign in glory, faithful heirs with Christ on high, join to ours your supplication, when before Christ we draw nigh, praying that this life completed, all its fleeting moments past,
Good morning again, my dear friends. Thank you for remaining with us in our adoration, monthly adoration and prayers during this time for the next hour. So we will have a silent adoration, and after that we will offer the prayers through the liturgy of the hours. It is called the office of readings. I will offer the prayers, and then you can pray along and meditate the Word of God. And so for exposition, please take this book, Breaking Bread, and turn in the inside back cover of the book as we prepare to sing the exposition song on the page of the back cover of the book. God bless you for the rest of your day. let us offer our prayers at this moment, the prayers, official prayers by the priest and the religious, and it is called part of the prayers of the day, Liturgy of the Hours, or specifically in this part, we pray the office of readings.
Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Come, let us worship our mighty King and Lord. Come, let us worship our King and Lord. Come, let us sing to the Lord, and shout with joy to the Rock who saves us. Let us approach him with praise and thanksgiving, and sing joyful songs to the Lord. Come, let us worship our mighty King and Lord. The Lord is God, the mighty God, the great King over all the gods. He holds in his hands the depths of the earth and the highest mountains as well. He made the sea, it belongs to him, the dry land too, for it was formed by his hands. Come, let us worship our mighty King and Lord. Come, let us bow down and worship, bending the knee before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are his people, the flock he shepherds. Come, let us worship our mighty King and Lord. Today, listen to the voice of the Lord. Do not grow stubborn as your fathers did in the wilderness, when at Meribah and Massah they challenged me and provoked me. Although they had seen all of my works, come, let us worship our mighty King and Lord. 40 years I endured that generation. I said, they are people whose hearts go astray, and they do not know my ways. So I swore in anger, they shall not enter into my rest. Come, let us worship our mighty King and Lord. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Come, let us worship our mighty King and Lord.
The Lord is just, he will defend the poor. Lord, why do you stand afar off and hide yourself in times of distress? The poor man is devoured by the pride of the wicked. He is caught in the schemes that others have made. For the wicked man boasts of his heart's desires, and covetous blasphemes and spurns the Lord. In his pride, the wicked says, he will not punish. There is no God. Such are his thoughts. His path is ever untroubled. Your judgment is far from his mind. His enemies he regards with contempt. He thinks, never shall I falter. Misfortune shall never be my lot. His mouth is full of cursing, guile, and oppression. Mischief and deceit under his tongue. He lies in wait among the reeds. The innocent he murders in secret. His eyes are on the watch for the helpless man. He lurks in hiding like a lion in his lair. He lurks in hiding to seize the poor. He seizes the poor man and drags him away. He crouches, preparing to spring, and the helpless fall beneath his strength. He thinks in his heart, God forgets. He hides his face. He does not see. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. The Lord is just. He will defend the poor. Lord, you know the burden of my sorrow. Arise then, Lord, lift up your hand. O God, do not forget the poor. Why should the wicked spurn the Lord and think in his heart, God will not punish? But you have seen the trouble and sorrow. You note it. You take it in hand. The helpless trusts himself to you, for you are the helper of the orphan. Break the power of the wicked and the sinner. Punish his wickedness till nothing remains. The Lord is king forever and ever. The heathen shall perish from the land he rules. Lord, you hear the prayer of the poor. You strengthen their hearts. You turn your ear to protect the rights of the orphaned and the oppressed, so that mortal men may strike terror no more. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Let us pray. Rise up, Lord, in defense of your people. Do not hide your face from our troubles. Father of orphans, wealth of the poor, we rejoice in making you known. May we find comfort and security in times of pain and anxiety. Lord, you know the burden of my sorrow. The words of the Lord are true, like silver from the furnace. Help, O Lord, for good men have vanished. Truth has gone from the sons of men. Falsehood they speak to one another, with lying lips, with false hearts. May the Lord destroy all lying lips, the tongue that speaks high shouting words, those who say, our tongue is our strength, our lips are our own. Who is our master? For the poor who are oppressed and the needy who groan, I myself will arise, says the Lord. I will grant them the salvation for which they thirst. The words of the Lord are words without alloy, silver from the furnace, seven times refined. It is you, O Lord, who will take us in your care and protect us forever from this generation. See how the wicked browse on every side, while the worthless are prized highly by the sons of men. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Let us pray. Your light is true light, Lord, and your truth shines like the day. Direct us to salvation through your life-giving words. May we be saved by always embracing your word. The words of the Lord are true, like silver from the furnace. The Lord teaches the humble his way. He guides the gentle-hearted along the right path.
first reading. Job said, I have made an agreement with my eyes and entertain no thoughts against a maiden. But what is man's lot from God above, his inheritance from the Almighty on high? Is it not calamity for the unrighteous and woe for evildoers? Does he not see my ways and number all my steps? Let God weigh in the scales of justice. Thus will he know my innocence. If I have walked in falsehood, and my foot has hastened to deceit, if my steps have turned out of the way, and my heart has followed my eyes, or any stain clings to my hands, then may I sow, but another eat of it, or may my planting be rooted up. Had I refused justice to my manservant or to my maid when they had a claim against me, what then should I do when God grows up? What could I answer when he demanded an account? Did not he who made me in the womb make me? Did not the same one fashion us before our birth? If I have denied anything to the poor or allowed the eyes of the widow to languish while I ate my portion alone, with no share in it for the fatherless, though like a father, God has reared me from my youth, guiding me even from my mother's womb. If I have seen a wanderer without clothing or a poor man without covering, whose limbs have not blessed me when warmed with the fleece of my sheep. If I have raised my hand against the innocent, because I saw that I had supporters at the gate, then may my arm fall from the shoulder, my forearm be broken at the elbow, for the dread of God will be upon me, and his majesty will overpower me. Oh, that I had one to hear my case, and that my accuser would write out his indictment. Surely I should wear it on my shoulder and put it on me like a diadem. Of all my steps, I should give him an account. Like a prince, I should present myself before him. Those are the words from the book of Job. Does not calamity befall the wicked, and disaster the evildoers? The eyes of the Lord are everywhere, observing the evil and the good. Does he not see my way and count all my steps? The eyes of the Lord are everywhere, observing the evil and the good. Second reading, from the teachings of the Saint Dorotheus Abbot. In false spiritual peace. The man who finds fault with himself accepts all things cheerfully, misfortune, loss, disgrace, dishonor, and any other kind of adversity. He believes that he is deserving of all these things, and nothing can disturb him. No one could be more at peace than this man. But perhaps you will offer me this objection. Suppose my brother injures me, and on examining myself, I find that I have not given him any cause. Why should I blame myself? Certainly, if someone examines himself carefully and with fear of God, he will never find himself completely innocent. He will see that he has given some provocation by an action, a word, or by his manner. If he not guilty in any of these ways, certainly he must have injured that brother somehow at some other time. Or perhaps he has been a source of annoyance to some other brother. For this reason, he deserves to endure the injury because of many other sins that he has committed on the other occasions. Someone else asks why he should accuse himself when he was sitting peacefully and quietly when a brother came upon him with an unkind or insulting word. He cannot tolerate it, and so he thinks that his anger is justified. If that brother had not approached him and said those words and upset him, he never would have sinned. This kind of thinking is surely ridiculous and has no rational basis. For the fact that he has said anything at all in this situation breaks the cover on the passionate anger within him, which is all the more exposed by his excessive anxiety. If he wished he would do penance, he has become like a clean, shiny grain of wheat that, when broken, is full of dirt inside. The man who thinks that he is quiet and peaceful has within him a passion that he does not see. A brother comes up, utters some unkind word, and immediately all the venom and mire that lie hidden within him are spewed out. If he wishes mercy, he must do penance, purify himself, and strive to become perfect. He will see that he should have returned thanks to his brother instead of returning the injury, because his brother has proven to be an occasion of profit to him. It will not be long before he will no longer be bothered by these temptations. The more perfect he grows, the less these temptations will affect him. For the more the soul advances, the stronger and more powerful it becomes in bearing the difficulties that it meets. Responsory. Truly I know that no man can stand justified before God. Who am I to answer God and choose words against him? God put no trust in his holy ones, and even the heavens are not pure in his sight. Who am I to answer God and choose words against him? Let us pray. Father, your love never fails. Hear our call, keep us from danger, and provide for all our needs. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Sanctum ergo sacramentum, veneremus genuini, et anticum documentum, novos et arituii, preste fide supplementum, sensum de fetum.
peace of the kingdom, where you live with the Father and Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please turn to the last song on the inside cover of the book.
Holy God, we praise thy name. Lord of all, we bow before thee. All on earth thy scepter claim. All in heaven above adore thee. Infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign. Infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign. Hark the loud celestial hymn, angel choirs above are raising, cherubim and seraphim in unceasing chorus praising, fill the heavens with sweet accord. Holy, holy, holy Lord, fill the heavens with sweet accord. Holy, holy, holy Lord.
Thank you, my dear friends, for participating in this holy hour. May God bless you. Please keep in touch with us, especially through the website, as we have special announcements to you the day ahead regarding to the reopening of our church and attendance of the Holy Mass with certain regulations and parameters that we need to observe together. So watch closely for the announcements on the website, in the bulletins, as well as during the Sunday Mass. May God bless you. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us spend this day in peace. Thanks be to God.